in order to go to the bank as often as possible, what you have to do with a prospect is ask effective questions, open questions, closed-end questions, even multiple choice questions, which I use for closing. You've got to ask the right questions like you're a diagnostician, like you're a professional. You cannot treat the patient. You cannot advise your client if you're an attorney, an accountant, or something like that, unless you have some information first. You have to know where it hurts. Where's the problem? Most people in sales, they rush in right away. They read their script. They go very intellectual. They do their slideshow and everything else. And then it's the prospect's turn to talk. And what you want to do is the 75-25 rule. Get the prospect speaking more than you. The way to do that is ask effective questions. Mr. and Mrs. Prospect, what's your time frame for doing this transaction? You don't want to really do this now, do you? You want to do it in 6 months? That's off the role play. That's when you ask a question with a redirection. You go negative to get the positive response and information, or you go positive to get the negative response. And there's different methods within the gut sales method: redirection, pattern interrupts, stroking, nurturing, empathy, all these different little things that are blended together, because guts is a question-based system. We ask a lot of questions and we ask permission for those questions, and we call that the agenda step. Mr. and Mrs. Prospect, can I ask you, I want to learn more about your situation so I can give you good advice or maybe a few solutions, and then I'm going to make you an offer to solve it. And you can say no to me, you can tell me I'm fired, that's all right. But is that all right? And you can ask me some questions too. Would you mind doing that? Boom, that's an agenda. Learn to ask, get permission for questions, then ask the right questions based on time frame. Do they have the money? Do they own the house if you're buying a house or something from them? Do they have the authority? Are they on the deed or the paperwork on it? Do they have the character to keep that commitment? What's their level of motivation? You want to find all these things out with nice, soft, nurturing and stroking type questions. Blend them with some stories and voila. You're going to find sales is so much easier because you're having this nice little interactive conversation with people. I love sales. I used to hate it, guys. Honestly, I was the former World's Worst Salesperson. And once I learned how to ask questions and get them emotionally involved, they gave me everything I needed to know how to close them on a silver platter. And it made sales fun. It made it extremely profitable. I have a great life and I'm very grateful for it. Okay. I've been there at 2 a.m. How am I going to pay the rent, Lord? Okay. And now I don't have those worries because I learned, thanks to my mentor, Max, how to sell. And these are the same things that you have to learn, how to ask good questions, because nobody deserves success more than you people. You're working hard, you're studying hard, and you have to, it doesn't matter how much knowledge you accumulate if you cannot get a commitment from the person you're dealing with. This is Claude Diamond. I do answer my own phone, 970-281-5151. And go to my webpage. A lot of free good stuff here, like the mind map behind me at claudediamond.com. Take care.